Okay, so who would like to tell me how this should be drawn, Haley?
I put a dot and then a line and then another dot.
A dot, line, dot, like this.
And then under one dot I put an A, and then under I put a B.
Does it matter which dot I put the A and the B under?
No.
No, it doesn't. It could be this way or it could be BA. All right, what about my high? Angelica. A dot? And I just put another little dot to show the I and over here by the arrow. Okay? So does it matter where the H and the I are?
No.
Oh, yes.
It does, Lydia. Why does it matter?
It matters because the dot stays there and the arrow keeps going.
Okay, and so this tells us specifically that it starts at H and continues on. So this one does matter the direction. All right, what about this one? What does this one look like, Riley? I'm going to go ahead and put a dot for the E. Here. Does it matter which order the E and the F go?
No.
They could be, they're interchangeable because it's the same on both sides. All right, what about my last little one here, Benny? Can it be any angle? We don't know the angle, so it could be any, it could be this kind of angle. It could be, what kind of angle is this classified as?
Acute.
Which one's this one?
Right angle.
And this one is?
Acute.
Okay, so we'll do a right angle. So what did you do then on a right angle? I'm going to go ahead and put my arrows too. Okay? At the vertice. Okay. What did you call this top dot? And the vertice dot? And this dot. All right, so this is one way to do it. Is there another way to represent this angle? Avani?
Y-O-T.
So I'm going to do this one. I could do Y-O-T. Is there another way I can represent the angle?
No.
Well, I can write it a different way. I can just, if I do this, and I put an O there, I could call this angle O, right? So that's another way to do it. All right, we're doing 10-2 today. Go ahead. A triangle is a polygon with three sides and three angles. You can name a triangle by the vertices of its angles. Real quick, who would like to remind me what polygon means? Go ahead and turn to your neighbor and tell them. Malia, why don't you share with us what a polygon is?
A polygon.
Very good. It's a plane figure that has to have straight lines and it has to be closed. Very good. All right. We're looking at a triangle here, and we've already learned how to name angles. Who can name this angle for me? Angle ABC. Very good. What's another name for that same angle? So what is the last option we can name that? Rachel? So we could do, hold on real quick, angle, we have ABC, we have angle, CBA, or angle B, just by itself. So we know how to name angles. We could name all of those angles. What is the name of this angle? Angle,
B-A-C.
Very good. And we could do the same thing here. Angle
A-C-B.
A-C-B. Very good. Now, when we're talking about a triangle, as you can see, they've shown all the different possible names. It doesn't matter what order the letters go in. We feel comfortable with ABC because that's ABC order, right? Alphabetical order. So that would be the most common that people would write. So triangle ABC or triangle BCA or CAB or ACB, it doesn't matter. Any one of those would work, as long as you have all three points in the triangle name. All right, an angle of a triangle can be right, acute, or obtuse. So let's look at this triangle right here. Look at angle B. Would you classify that, think in your head first, acute, obtuse, or a right angle? Raise your hand when you know. What do you guys think?
Acute.
All right, let's look at angle C. Think.
Acute.
Okay, now look at angle A. And what would you call that one?
Obtuse.
It's bigger than right, and if I'm not sure, I can take my little piece of paper, just any old piece of paper, and look at how much bigger than a right angle it is. My finger's not there, you can see that it's yellow. There you go. But see how much bigger than a right angle it is? What if one of the angles is acute, or two of the angles are acute, and one is obtuse? How do you decide what to call that, whether it's acute, a right angle, or an acute triangle, an obtuse triangle, or a right triangle? How can I tell I have two acutes and one obtuse? Does anybody have an idea? Preston? I mean, Karis? Okay, so he says you would call this obtuse because it's bigger than a right angle. This one's bigger than a right angle. And he's right. Every triangle is going to have acute angles. At least two acute angles. They have to, otherwise they can't close. So every triangle is going to have at least two acute angles. You're trying to decide that third angle. Is it acute, obtuse, or right? And whatever that third angle is going to be your decision. Now, obviously, if you think you found the third angle and it's acute, you better check all the angles and make sure they're all acute. Okay, let's start looking at these. If it has a right angle, you will do red. If it has an obtuse angle, we'll do blue. And if it has three acute angles, then we'll do orange. Remember, all triangles are gonna have at least two acute angles. Okay, so let's go ahead and go with the first one. What's this angle?
Acute.
This one?
Acute.
And that one?
Acute.
So what color am I gonna color this triangle?
Orange.
What about this angle here? Is this?
Acute.
Everybody together, please. Obtuse and?
Acute.
So definitely two acutes, but there's an obtuse, so that one's going to be
blue.
This one down here. This is?
Right.
Acute.
Very good. So what color is this one going to be?
Red.
Do you see any more right triangles in here?
Yes.
Is this a right triangle?
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
It does kind of sound creepy. Okay, let's look at this one. What is this angle?
Acute.
So this should be?
Blue.
Blue.
Acute.
So it's going to be?
Orange.
So do you see what I mean? How each triangle has to have at least two acute angles, and you're just deciding is the third angle acute, obtuse, or right? And then you classify that triangle based on what that third angle is. Okay, this one?
Acute.
What's this last one?
Obtuse.
Obtuse. So it's going to be blue. Name the triangle with one right angle. So look at the triangles over here, these three triangles, and decide which one of them has one right angle. Really, which one has one right angle? What would the triangle be called? Does it matter what order the letters go in?
No,
it does not matter on the triangles which order the letters go in. Name the triangle with one obtuse angle. Who can tell me the name or a name for one of the for the triangle that has an obtuse angle? I should. Okay, so triangle XZ Y. Do we have to call it X, Z, Y?
No.
No, we can call it Z, Y, X. We can call it
Y, X, Z,
whatever. Okay, number three, or letter C. Name the triangle with three acute angles. I want you to turn to your neighbor, and I want you to each share a different name for it. Go ahead. What did you decide to name it?
A, B, C.
Triangle, A, B, C. Okay. Is that the only name you can name it?
No.
No, there's several ways that you can name this triangle. All right. If the triangle has all acute angles, it is called a
acute triangle.
An acute triangle. If the triangle has one obtuse angle, we call it a
or obtuse triangle.
What is it?
An obtuse triangle.
Very good. And if it has one right angle, we call it?
Right triangle.
A right triangle. And so now you already know, because we've already gone over these, but those are the names of the three different types of triangles. That's how we classify it. So let's look at the first triangle. Triangle SRT or TRS, it doesn't matter. Triangle SRT, Angeli. Acute triangle. Go ahead and write it with me. SRT is an acute triangle. Okay, look at the angle, the triangle underneath it. Look at this triangle. Raise your hand if you know which circle it should go. It's a right triangle. Go ahead and call it whatever you want. Use all three letters. All right, let's look at this triangle. It's obtuse. Okay, the triangle underneath it with A, B, and C in it. It's a cute one. The one with L, M, N. Jalen. It is an acute triangle. The one with E, F, D. Preston.
Obtuse.
Obtuse. The one with C, D, and B. Ronnie. And the one with G, H, and I. Name the triangle. Tell whether each angle is acute, right, or obtuse. So looking at this triangle over here, we can tell because it has what? It has the little right angle sign. So what kind of triangle is it?
Right angle.
What is a name you can give this right triangle? What is one name that you can give this right triangle? Erin. Triangle GHF. Don't forget to put the triangle sign, otherwise I don't know what you're talking about. Okay, so angle F is what kind of angle? Is looking at it, you have to decide, is it acute, obtuse, or right? What do you guys think?
Acute.
Look at angle G. Malia, what do you think angle G is? It's a right angle. And angle H, look at it. What do you think, class?
Cute.
Cute. Remember, you cannot have a right triangle with an obtuse angle.